It's Saturday morning in the control room in Nottingham, and an alarming call has just come in.
Police emergency, what's the emergency?
My neighbour tried to break my door with an axe.
Okay, is he still there now?
No, now he's gone.
When did this happen?
A few minutes ago.
Do you know who this person is?
He's my neighbour, I don't know his name. I know he's a junkie.
Response cops Lewis Marshall and Lee Barlow are on duty, so the job is passed to them.
Just had a call from a male banging on the door with an axe.
You've got a neighbour that's done something bizarre, so you've got to question where he's at, you know, what sort of mentality he's got.
As they approach the address, Lee quickly spots the property that's been attacked.
Yes, there is a big hole in the door.
As soon as we pulled up and I saw the attacked door, I just thought, that's an axe.
Try to come inside of the house. He has a sword and an axe inside of his hand and tried to block the door.
Did you see him do it?
No. My mother, she was inside. She was calling me. I was outside. He's living right here next to me. It's not the first time when it's happening. One time, the
is
door was...
Is your mom in now?
Yeah, with my sister as well.
Do you have any idea why he's done it?
I don't know, sir. He's mental. I know he's using something.
The neighbour that attacked the door has gone back inside his own house next door.
The whole family were visibly shaken. They were very scared. Obviously, quite traumatised by what had just happened.
Confronting the neighbour, who could be armed with a sword and an axe, has given the cops a difficult decision to make. Go in now or wait for backup.
Public safety is paramount, and if he's prepared to do that, how is he still in the property? And you think, is he going to come out again in the very near future and do something similar?
What they're saying.
Lee calls in to see if there are any taser-armed cops nearby.
We're about to knock on, just wondering if we've got a taser resource available.
Lewis and I are both in agreement. We need to, you know, get this guy out the address, make sure he's got no weapons, and make sure there's no one else in there, you know, that need our help.
But with no taser officers immediately available, Lewis prepares to use his CS gas, a form of tear gas that stings the eyes.
From my point of view, we sort of stood outside his house. He might know we're outside, probably does know we're outside his house, and I wanted to get him out then, sort of at that moment.
Steve, get off the radio, mate, one sec.
Please! Your hands where I can see him.
He opened the door but wouldn't fully present himself out of it, I noticed immediately.
Catches up with the runner. Lewis sprays the CS gas in his face. This time, the CS gas has hit the target and the axeman has been forced to stop. But he's not the only one with streaming eyes.
I got a full face of it.
The man's arrested and restrained by other officers while Lee and Lewis search his house. Inside, using their body cameras to record evidence of anything they find, they quickly come across a small arsenal of deadly-looking weapons.
In the front room, there's a machete and another axe. He's kidding. And then in the window, there's an ornamental samurai-type sword, capable of causing lethal harm.
And there's something else in the hallway.
We have confirmed just inside the door as well, there's appears to be a hand axe, which is consistent with the damage caused to the neighbour address.
And hand axe in the house?
Yeah, just on the inside of the front door.
My thoughts were, he's been seen to have some weapons, that if he comes to the door, we need him out fast. So, with the information we've been armed with, I think it feels appropriate to try and pull him out. You know, reasonable force, and then as soon as he's got out, he started to swing, at which point I backed off and used my gas.
You open our car.
Yeah.
Quite a large hand axe, a very large machete, and then some kind of decorating tool, I suppose. All three. I mean, this one, you can still see the white plastic on the end of the axe. And that's obviously come from the damage that he's caused to the next door. But very nasty tools.
But the menacing weapons aren't the only things they find. In the kitchen of the man's house, another discovery is made that could shed some light on his behaviour.
Looks like it's some kind of amphetamine, been kept in the freezer. He's obviously got a set of digital scales here where he's been cutting it up. And he'll be using that as some kind of cutting compound. So, yeah, suspected to be drugs. Doesn't appear to be intoxicated, so yeah, it may well be under the influence of some other substance, which is why he's done what he's done to his neighbour's house and why he's reacted to us the way he has when we've knocked on the door. So we'll seize that, we'll get it field tested, and that'll tell us exactly what it's going to be.
The neighbour whose door was smashed is understandably worried about living there.
This guy's coming back, sir?
Well, he will be released at some point, yeah. Obviously, he's your next-door neighbour. Chances are he'll be given conditions where he's not allowed to have any contact with you guys. If he sees you on the street, he's not allowed to speak to you and he should really be crossing the street. So you've not had any previous fallouts with him or anything?
No. Just one time I was sitting inside of the kitchen and I saw him with the sword and the knife. And like that, just like that, straight away. And after, like, 1 minute, he was, like, going back down.
You didn't tell us about
it? No, because I'm scared, you know, she's...
Yeah.
We don't want...
You don't want trouble or anything?
Yeah.
Okay.
This time, what can I do, sir? What can I do?
Well, yeah, you've done the right thing this time.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Okay. No problem. Sure. He's obviously come out wanting to fight, and now can go to the cell and just sleep off whatever is affecting his behaviour at the minute.
The cops have got another problem. The man's small dog, which got caught up in the chase. Arrangements are made to make sure it's looked after.
It's got water, it's got food.
Has it?
Yeah.
Okay. It's a tiny thing, it doesn't need much, does it?
It's got a bit of excitement to it, though, but...
The evidence Lee and Lewis have found in the house will go towards securing a conviction.
I think, end of the day, there's a family next door, absolutely terrified of him. They've had the door smashed to pieces with his weapons, and now we've locked him up and, you know, they can...
Why have you got all these sort of things in your house? If he's prepared to go out and use them on his next-door neighbour's door, where does that stop?
The following day, more harrowing details came to light when Lee took a statement from a teenage girl at the address.
Turned out the sword he'd actually pierced through the door and, like, thrust it through the entire door up to the hilt. And the 14-year-old girl was walking towards the door when the blade came straight through. And she's had to literally jump back to avoid being run through with it.
During the scuffle with the axeman, as well as getting a face full of CS gas, Lee also got a fist in the face.
It's the only time I've been punched in the face in 14 years. So I got punched by an offender and then CS by my colleague.
The axeman pleaded guilty to criminal damage, possession of an offensive weapon in a public place, and assaulting a police officer. He was sentenced to a hospital order without time limit. The sword was seized, and he was also convicted of being in possession of amphetamines.